Learn how to add personality to your chatbot in this episode of the AI Show, where Ron shows us all about the humorous, friendly, and maybe even buttoned up AI that you can add to your chatbots in this episode of the AI Show. Welcome to a new episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about a little bit about bots with Ron. How are you doing, my friend?
I am good. How are you?
Tell us who you are and what you do.
Well, my name is Ron Owens. I'm on Project Personality Chat, and I am one of the writers and editors on the team developing a service for bot developers.
Fantastic. So tell us the problem that this is solving.
When you're a bot, you build a bot, and what happens with a bot is sometimes people don't stay on rails. You designed a bot to do something, but they go off and ask some unusual query, and we call these queries chitchat or small talk. And so when a bot encounters small talk, often what will happen is the bot will just sort of
explode.
No explosions, not that I've heard of. They'll just say, "Sorry, I don't understand." Like you're chatting with your bank bot, and the bank bot says, "Hey, you got more money in your bank account than you thought you did," and you can't contain your enthusiasm, and you say something exuberant, then the bot says, doesn't get it, and it says, "Sorry, I don't understand." And so, not only is this just, no fun, but it's distracting, and the experience just feels broken. And for a bot developer to go in and try to find these areas, these trouble areas, and try to fix them would just be a huge endeavor. There's help out there. You can find bot platforms that will help you in areas like this. They provide sort of an editorial starter set, but they're insufficient. They're insufficient solutions, and that's where we're trying to come in with this. And the Project Personality Chat, what we provide is we provide the bot developer with a consistent personality, and we provide the bot developer with a choice of personalities. And this is essential if you're designing a bot and you want this bot to, its voice to sort of align with your brand. Other bot developer platforms, they really just provide a one size fits all solution. So you just get that one voice, and you get at best a limited set of responses for those top sort of chit chat and small talk queries.
And what's interesting is, like just to not interrupt, but when you are going through a bot experience, mm-hmm. and all of a sudden you hit the limits of what the bot does, then all of a sudden you're sort of pulled from the experience, and you're like, this is kind of artificial.
Yeah.
Now I know
yeah.
I'm talking to a robot, I'm gonna screw with it, or yeah. do whatever, yeah. right? yeah. And so this is a way to help in those cases, is that right?
Right, exactly, okay. exactly. So yeah, we're helping you in that area, and like I say, you have choices, and I can show you.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's look at it.
What it looks like. So this is a weather bot
okay.
that we've set up, and so we are providing you. We're trying to help you not hit that dead end. The where it says I don't know what you're talking about. We have two ways of doing that. We have an editorial set of responses for the most common small talk queries, and then we have those are for those top queries, those high volume queries, and we have these for each of the personality types that we've mapped out, and for the longer tail queries. So you can't predict everything everyone's
yeah,
going to say, and for those long top long tail queries, we have a deep neural network. This is cutting edge stuff, this deep neural network on the back end, and it will generate responses in real time. Yes.
Not Eliza, but like the real
yes,
stuff.
yes. Here, this weather bot, what we have is, this is just has the editorial set hooked up to it. So I'm gonna, but it does have personality, and this one is our humorous bot. It's tuned to the humorous personality. I'm just gonna say hi to start our conversation. Oh, what's cooking? All right.
Wow, that is a lot of personality right off the bat.
So now let's get down to business. I'm going to say, how's the weather there in Botland? Okay, so it recognized that as a functional query. It wasn't small talk, so it gave me a good answer. And
it sort of appended a little humor there at the end.
Yeah. That's a fun part of it. Okay, so now I'm going to say, how are you? 85%. Okay, who made you? Nerds. Yeah, nice. Pretty accurate. Okay. Do you like them?
Nice.
So you don't hang out? Oops. Okay, so here we've hit the edge of the editorial set. This is when we go to the, here I'm going to show you the other solution.
I see. So this is like, you have an editorial set of things that it's like, here, you want humor? Just here's the humor for the 99% or whatever percentage of things people will ask. You have a flow for that already built in. Mm-hmm. So if they're reaching the edges of your of what you're supposed to be doing with the bot, then it'll take care of it. But then if you get into the weirder things or different things that it doesn't know about, that's when you use what you're showing us.
Well, the bot will probably have a purpose. You probably built this bot, like this one was built to tell the weather.
Right.
And so, you know, ideally if you're the developer, they're going to talk about the weather.
Right.
But they're also going to ask some weird stuff. And yeah, that's for the more common weird stuff. We're the same team who created Cortana's persona.
I see.
Personality. We created that, and so it's the same team. So we're very familiar with the stuff that people will ask. It's not on task.
I see. That's cool.
So that's what the editorial set is about. But they're even going to go beyond this, and let's see if I can get over to the other. Yes. Cool. So this is a. This is in beta, but it's available right now at the Cognitive Services Labs, mm-hmm. as one of their offerings. And so this will handle those long tail queries. And you have a choice of personalities here. These models have been trained in these. This is so cool. they are trained. Per these personalities. So you have a choice of personalities, and you got the editorial set. The whole editorial set has been customized for these individual personalities. So differentiating in that way, and the long tail, the machine-generated responses are also tuned to these personality types.
So there's no settings that I have to do. It just does it, based upon what we've learned from Cortana and other things that we have in
Yes, we've applied our Cortana learnings to know those top queries, what those are going to be. You got those the editorial set, and then you have the long tail queries being answered by this machine that's being spontaneously generated. But you, as a bot developer, you can go in and you can customize the editorial set. You can go in and you can change these responses. You'll get the library and just go in there and if you don't like what we've given you or if you it's just a huge time saver in that and expense saver to have these identified for you, those top queries, and to have this to not have to start from scratch.
Cool. And all right, let's see this right here.
Okay, sure.
So I'm curious to see what personality types are, like angry father, mother-in-law, you know, none of those?
No, what we're trying to do is we are trying to develop voices that will support sort of brand archetypes.
Got it.
Right now we have three. We have professional, friendly, and humorous. There will be more, but that's where we are now. So I've set this to friendly. So I'm going to start by I'm going to give it a. This is just to demonstrate the chat.
Right.
So this is not like the weather bot. This isn't supposed to be doing anything functional, but except demonstrate this deep neural
tail.
Network. Yes. Okay, so I want to say, how's the weather?
Is it at the top?
Yep, there it is. Okay, so I did that on purpose. what it's doing is it recognized that as not being chat. So there's a chat classifier that's applied to this. So it's only responding to chat queries. It doesn't want to get in the way of fact-based conversations or any task-oriented conversations. It's staying out of the way of that and only answering these chat queries.
Which in theory, like if you think about it, if you're building a bot, mm-hmm. when it comes to specific things, that's what your bot should be working on.
Yes.
But when it works around the periphery, yeah. then you're like, okay, that's not for me. We'll let the AI take care of that.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
right,
that's
right.
cool.
So now I will ask it some, okay, the screen setup here is not ideal, but let's see, what did I ask last time? I said, why is it hi? And it says, hey, what's up?
Who made you?
Oh yeah, okay, let's try that. Who made you? And this is our friendly bot, so it'd probably be friendlier. Lots and lots of people, so that's nice.
It looks like on the right-hand side, it's giving you some probability
yes.
scores of what it could tell you.
Yes,
too.
These are, figuring out which response to give you, and whichever one gets the best score wins, and that's what it delivers.
Got it.
So you get to see, that's kind of fun to watch too. What did I ask next?
Do you like them?
Okay, yes. Do you like them? Yes, I do. They are very nice. So that's awesome. We did not write that. The machine just wrote that for us.
Wow.
And also wrote us some other stuff too. So yeah. And so this is, like I said, in beta, but it's going to be available very soon. Mm-hmm. And any bot can call this API, and you're going to have this long tail completely covered.
And the cool thing is, like, when you're writing these bots, there always comes a point where you're like, I don't know what to do with this, and you have the default, sorry, I don't understand. Mm-hmm. But now you can go and, like, farm that out to this mm-hmm. and let it do its thing. Is that correct?
Yeah, you're still going to hit it. There's still going to be things. We like I said, we try to stay away from tasks and when you want a real factual answer. Uh-huh. And we've limited the classifier to certain chat subject areas.
I see.
But it could answer any sort of chat query. But right now we're limiting it to those subject areas.
How do you plug into this? Is there like an API that you call?
There is an API, yes. And you just call the API and your bot will be super smart.
Well, this has been amazing. The one thing that I've always had a challenge with bots is what do I do when I reach the edge? And it looks like mm-hmm. this is a really good way to fill the stopgap.
Yeah, you're going to you'll have the long tail covered, and these personalities are going to be great. You're going to be able to differentiate your bot and make it speak well for your brand. If you're a wacky brand, you might have a humorous bot,
nice.
Or you want to keep it buttoned up. You can take the professional bot. So great differentiator.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for spending some time with us.
Sure.
Thanks so much for watching. We've been looking at how to fill the gap in your bot when we reach the edge with personality chat. Thanks so much for spending some time with us.
Oh, you bet.
Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.
Thanks.